The budget on an overall basis is focused towards growth, infrastructure development, and the Atmanirbhar Bharat initiative. The government has extended the ECLGS scheme validity till March 2023, and the coverage of the scheme has also been extended from rupees 4.5 lakh crore to rupees 5 lakh crore. The additional amount has been earmarked for the hospitality sector, which was severely affected during the pandemic. The CGT MSE scheme will also be revamped with the required infusion of funds and will lead to additional rupees 2 lakh crore credit to the MSME units. Now, coming on to the virtual digital currency related points. The RBI will introduce digital rupee using blockchain technology. Also, the much needed tax clarity for virtual digital currency transaction has been spelled out in this budget. A 30% tax on transfer of this asset will apply, with no expense except cost of acquisition to be allowed against such income. If there is a loss on transfer of such asset, it will not be allowed to set off against any other head of income. Additionally, TDS at the rate of 1% would be required to be deducted on transfer of such digital currency assets. Capping of surcharge on long-term capital gain tax at the rate of 15% has also been introduced. Now, the assessees will be allowed to file an updated return within 2 years from the end of relevant assessment year if they have missed out on disclosing any income while filing their original return.